Welcome back once again. So in the previous video we have done with the draggable and droppable. So here in this video we are using accordion. So that is another thing. Accordions, like if you see over there, it looks like this. Okay, this is called as accordion. And how we can use in our project or our pages here. So for that we just have to go to view source. So here it is having only one function. The function is called, and to this we have given id of accordion as method. Accordion is called over there. Then we are having some HTML code over there. So no, okay, so start writing. We will be using small code over there. So here we go. In the body part we will create div. And to that I will give id as say accordion, or I give id to that as list, say. Then within that I'm using a header, say h3, and here I type list1, and to this I will use another div. Head, good. I will use another div over here. And here I will use paragraph. And here we write some text. Goes here. For example, and this my div is closed. Okay, so same way I will repeat it for 3 times. Okay, and the list one here I give it list 2, and let it list 3, and some text goes here. Here I write 2, here I write 3. Okay, so I save this. Here we go, refresh it, browser scene. It looks like this way in my case. List 1, some text goes here. List 2, some text goes here. It's display all the 3 dips over there. We wanted to display only one dip at a time, and if we click on the second, and that will be open and another one will be closed. That is what called the accordion. So in order to use this accordion, we will write some style to this. So let I style it in the header section. So for this I will use style element, and here we go with this. So first I will have written id list. So for the list I will style it like this way. In my list I just want to have some background color over there to identify. So background color, and to this I will give a value like say gray. Then color, that is text that is on this, is given a value. Say I'm just giving it value as somewhat matching to the gray. Then I need to change the cursor over there. So cursor I want is of pointer type. Then one more thing that I need to add over there is I need padding of each side, that is 20 pixel say around. Then padding is there. Then I will set the width of this. सोफ्टवेयर टाइम टेकिंग अराउंड 80% ऑफ द ब्यूबल एरिया, सो दैट आई सेट द विड्थ 80%. देन आई सेट द टेक्स्ट अलाइंड टू द लेफ्ट, टेक्स्ट अलाइंड टू द लेफ्ट. देन I won't want border for this, so I will set border to none. Border I don't want for this, outline even I don't want for this, outline none. Then I want some transition for this. And that is of around 0.4 second. Okay. Save this here. Here we go, refresh it. It looks somewhat like this. Okay, I don't want this to be display here, so I want to add some hover effect to this. So I will take another ID, say ID active comma ID list Uber and to this I will add say background color. I will change for this. Hash this time taking this color. Okay, submit matching to the white. Say I will take another class over there to hide some panel. So I'm taking another class over there, hash panel ID over there, panel, and to this I'm writing here as padding zero and say around 20 pixel. Here I'm just giving a background color to this as white, and here I would like to display none, and overflow hidden. Okay, so overflow hidden over there. Save it here. And now this time we have to give this ID list over to this and say I will get ID equal to panel to this, and here we take it again ID panel. That this again ID panel. Okay, so here we go, save this, and again we will refresh it. Okay, so now we have to give the hidden accordion effect to this. So see this, this is created over there, it looks like this way, so it's working. I know, so we just have to simply try to understand over there. As we have created a list class, a list ID over there, in which we have set the background color to gray, or this time we can set it I just wanted to make some more color, this background color. Same. Blurry board. Say, how did it look like? Yeah, it's fantastic. On hover it changes. Okay, so it's working. So this way we can use accordion in our system. So for this we have to include this header files of JS files over in our project, and then we have made this CSS for this, and here we have used this function in which we have selected the element by its ID, and to that we have given the accordion effect, and then we have created a list and all these things. So this way we can create a accordion in our HTML page using the jQuery API. Okay, so that's all for now. So I think there is a lot more to do in jQuery, so that you can learn it by practicing over there. So in my next video we will going to start with a major project, that is a visual editor. Okay, so how that works, that we see in the next video. Till then, bye.